Martin Luther King, Rosa Parks, Malcolm X, Viola Liuzzo. This list of influential people contains some of the most important faces in the entire civil rights movement. But therein lies a name that many might not recognize, Viola Liuzzo. This is a name that is incredibly overshadowed, yet one that we must appreciate, as she did absolute wonders in the fight against segregation. Viola Gregg Liuzzo was born in April of 1925 in the small town of California, Pennsylvania. Circumstances were not preferable. Her father, Heber, was a coal miner, and her mother, Eva, was a teacher that struggled in finding work. This teaching job required constant moving, and Liuzzo never had the opportunity to acclimate. During these moves, Liuzzo lived in segregated areas such as Georgia, and saw firsthand the injustices and maltreatment encountered by African Americans. She would later move to Detroit, Michigan with her family. At age 18, Liuzzo met and married George Argyris while working as a waiter. They had two daughters and divorced 7 years later. While still working as a waiter, Liuzzo would go on to meet her next husband, Anthony. They had three children. Liuzzo was an impactful mother. She often took her children on walks and taught them Henry David Thoreau's civil disobedience. She knew what it meant to be caring and knew when it was time to stand up against wrongfulness. These characteristics would set Liuzzo up for her amazing work in the civil rights movement. Liuzzo's first major act of civil disobedience came during her time at Parkview Medical Center while working as a medical assistant. During her time working there, she began to realize that men were receiving more work and pay opportunities than women. In an attempt to expose this, she falsely told local police that she was going to steal a microscope from the laboratory. When arrested, she didn't have charges pressed against her, because she hadn't stolen, in fact. But she cleverly used the publicity to reveal the unfair treatment towards women in her workplace. In an interview, her husband Jim said that she was a fighter who never gave up when she thought she was right. This attitude would carry on into her involvement in the civil rights movement. On March 7th, 1965, black protesters, enraged by the killing of Jimmie Lee Jackson, another black protester, the month before at an Alabama courthouse, marched towards the Edmund Pettus Bridge in Alabama. What awaited them were troopers, armed and ready to subdue the march forcibly. The protesters nevertheless advanced and were promptly beaten and bruised horribly. 17 people were hospitalized on the so-called Bloody Sunday. Liuzzo sitting in her house appalled. Soon after, she took part in a protest at a nearby Wayne State University. Here she learned Martin Luther King's words, saying that this was everybody's fight. This struck a chord in her soul, and she knew it was her calling to help. She tearfully left her family and traveled down to Selma, Alabama. Liuzzo quickly became an active member in the black community. She was in the Detroit chapter of the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, aka the NAACP, and enlisted in the Southern Christian Leadership Conference under names such as Martin Luther King Jr. The goal of this organization was to end discrimination through nonviolent action. It took much resilience to enlist in this group, as fighting back was no option. This was yet another admirable quality of Liuzzo. She was calm and collective, but heavily persistent in doing what she thought was right. After a few days in Selma, Liuzzo was informed that a march was being scheduled for March 21st. This march would be of vast proportion, as protesters planned to go from Selma to Montgomery. The goal of the march was to call attention to black voting rights. Protesters wanted to get Governor George Wallace's attention for this, and saw this march as the best way in doing so. On that day, around 3,000 men and women of all race and background gathered to begin their peaceful march. Famous names such as Martin Luther King and Ralph Abernathy joined along. During this march, protesters were protected by the U.S. Army and National Guard troops. Liuzzo marched alongside and helped tremendously by driving people from Selma to Montgomery. 5 days later, the march ended and was capped with a fantastic speech by Martin Luther King.
I come to say to you this afternoon, however difficult the moment,
yes, sir,
however frustrating the hour, it will not be long. because truth crushed to earth will rise again.
Yes, sir.
How long, not long.
In this famous How Long, Not Long speech, Martin Luther King says fiercely that this was a shining moment in American history. Viola Liuzzo had taken a vital role in this shining moment. She dropped everything she had in Michigan and traveled to one of the most unstable areas of the United States in order to do what she thought was right. She, a white woman, associated with and befriended countless black folk. She sat side by side with them in her car as she transported them back and forth. She feared not what others thought. Her mere conscience and sense of morality drove her to these actions. After the march, Liuzzo was once again happy to drive people back to Selma. On a routine drive with passenger Leroy Moten, a young black protester that she had befriended, Liuzzo found herself being approached and attacked by a car with four white men in it. These men were part of the Ku Klux Klan, a controversial group that preached white power and demanded the continuation of segregation. Liuzzo tried to escape this attack, but...
It was a no-no for black and white to ride together, especially a black man and a white woman. If a black was riding with white, he's supposed to sit in the back seat.
In the back seat.
And this here was a no-no. Here's a white woman riding around with a black boy in her car, you know, minding her own business, trying to help get people back and forth to their home from point A to point B. And this was a no-no.
Leroy Moten, the passenger in the car on that day, played dead after being shot at and lived to give this interview some 50 years later. It truly was a no-no for a white and black passenger to ride together. And on March 25th, 1965, Viola Liuzzo was killed while doing what she believed in her heart was right. Her funeral was held on March 30th. Many prominent figures attended, including the famous Dr. King. Following this death and funeral, Viola Liuzzo was unfortunately given a horrible reputation, which, in turn, crafted a bad legacy. Southerners, upset with her relations with African Americans, made rumors that she had traveled to Selma to have intimate relations, which gave off the impression that she was cheating and a bad mother. In fact, a July 1965 poll in the Ladies' Home Journal revealed that 55% of women believed that she was not a good mother. The trial of the four murderers did not help this case. As it would turn out, one of the men in the car was Gary Thomas Rowe, a paid FBI informant trying to spy in on the KKK. J. Edgar Hoover, leader of the FBI, did not want to have a poor name associated with the organization, and began to spread false rumors about Liuzzo to divert attention. Yet, this poor image of Miss Liuzzo has ultimately not overshadowed what wonderful work she did. Her children continue her legacy, and in a 2015 interview, Penny Harrington, her daughter, said that she wanted people to remember her mom as the mom and woman that she was. And she is truly honored as so, a caring civil rights martyr who always knew goodness in her heart. Ultimately, Liuzzo took one of the greatest stands in civil rights history. She followed her sense of morality and made the ultimate sacrifice, giving her own life to the cause. She made advances in women's appreciation by exposing injustices in the workplace, and did all that she could to fight segregation. She was the only white woman to die during the civil rights movement. Although her name isn't written all over history textbooks, Viola Liuzzo is a woman that took an immense stand in history. One might wonder why this is the case. Perhaps her reputation was shattered by her post-death rumors. Maybe the fact that she was white was insignificant to the black leaders such as Malcolm X or Martin Luther King. Her being a woman may even play in. Nevertheless, Viola Liuzzo was a truly significant figure in the civil rights movement that took a stand for what she believed to be right, and nothing can conceal that.